Australia's first locally made rocket is preparing to get shot into space. The finishing touches are right now being made on the unmanned rocket in North Queensland.
And for the latest on the space mission, we're joined this morning by CEO of Gilmore Space Tech, Adam Gilmore on the Gold Coast, and Director of Launch Vehicles and Satellites, David Doyle, who's in Bowen. Firstly to you, Adam, hello there. How much work has gone into getting to this point?
Well, we started this particular vehicle program in 2019, so it's getting up to 5 years now. And, you know, we're in Australia where we don't have a lot of engineers with experience, so we've had to do a lot of learning on the way. And it's been a real journey, but I'm really, really happy to see the rocket finished, and I cannot wait until we launch it.
I mean, it looks like the real deal.
Looks good.
Not that I know anything about rockets. The name of the rocket is Eris. What is its purpose?
Well, Eris is named because it's a moon that's out near the orbit of Pluto, and we eventually want to get out that far with our vehicles. But this particular rocket is designed to take small satellites into low Earth orbit, and those are the majority of the satellites that are actually orbiting the Earth and delivering all kinds of capability down to us here.
I'd say good morning to David in Bowen. Dave, thanks for your time. What sort of work are you doing between now and the rehearsal launch?
Yeah, there's quite a bit of work to be done, but we're almost there. So we're about 4 to 5 weeks away, we feel, from T0, which is the ignition point. The big major milestones that we have ahead of us are what we call the dry dress rehearsal, the wet dress rehearsal, and of course the all-important launch permit is the last milestone coming from the Australian Space Agency. So those three major milestones, as we tick off those over the coming weeks, that'll move us closer to ignition point and closer to Australia having its first orbital rocket and orbital launch in history.
How significant is this?
Yeah, it's incredibly significant, predominantly because of its uniqueness. So Australia will become one of very few countries in the world that has an orbital launch capability. There's currently 12 in some cases when you look at the breakup of countries previously that have this this capability. So we'll be part of a very exclusive club. There is currently an enormous bottleneck of satellites waiting to be launched into low Earth orbit at the moment. And so this will be a really, really important and unique capability, not just for Australia, but also for our region. Just to put it into context, there's only 8 countries that have developed nuclear submarine capabilities, which is quite a hot topic at the moment. So it's around about the same sort of level of significance and uniqueness.
Do you have a viewing area there where people can come to Bowen and check it out?
There will be, yes, at a safe distance. We'll have a viewing area that will be promulgated. Stay tuned to our social media and our communications. Look out on the website and there'll be updates coming with launch dates and also how to access the viewing areas and any other communications that will come out.
Adam, can I ask why? Why did you want to do this here in Australia?
Well, I'm Australian and I lived overseas for quite a while and I've always been interested in space. I had a career in banking for quite a long time, but I wanted to do something more important with my life. And I looked at the industry as it was going to grow significantly. You know, Australia doesn't have any capability. I wanted to come back and do it here so I could prove to the nation that we can do very difficult things here. And Dave's sitting right in front of a rocket that shows that we can.
Yeah, wow.
So when is liftoff? Have you got a weekend today exclusive for us or is it weather dependent?
It's weather dependent. Dave's the right guy to tell you that, okay. But I think we're initially looking at a window that opens towards the end of the month.
Dave?
Well, I'll leave that to, sorry to bounce it back and forth, but We've got some upcoming key tests this week, okay. And we'll have a very good good idea of what the date will be. But as Adam mentioned, it'll be likely that we'll open the launch window at the end of April.
It's very cool. Good on you guys.
Watch this space, quite literally.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thanks, guys.